Hello everyone, welcome back to your science class. Today we will continue the same chapter, light and shadow. Children, today's first topic is formation of day and night. You all know that we live on the planet Earth. It is the third planet in our solar system. And due to the presence of water on Earth, it looks blue and called as a blue planet. The Earth looks like a huge sphere or a ball, and it constantly keeps on moving around the sun. This movement of Earth around the sun is called revolution. And because of the revolution of Earth, there are changes in season. Means because of this revolution, we experience different seasons on the Earth. Along with this movement around sun, Earth keeps on moving round and round on its axis, just like a top. So this spinning of Earth on its axis is called rotation. And because of the rotation of the Earth, there is formation of day and night. Children, Earth completes its one rotation in 24 hours and one revolution around sun in a year. That is 365.25 days. And after 4 years, it forms a leap year that have 366 days. Children, as you learn that rotation of Earth causes day and night. At a time, only one side of the Earth faces the sun and gets light from the sun. Thus, there is daytime on this side. The other side of the Earth, which is away from the sun, does not get heat and light from the sun. So, there is darkness. That is, it has night in this side. And you learn that Earth rotates. So, as the Earth rotates, during 24 hours, the side of Earth that had night now faces the sun and gets the light from the sun. Thus, it gets day now, and the other side experiences night. As you can see on the screen, the side of Earth which is in front of sun gets light, there is day, whereas the other side which do not get light from the sun has night. And due to the rotation of the Earth, the side which has night now faces the sun and it gets day now. So this rotation continues and we experience day and night. Let us understand this with an activity. For doing this activity, you need a globe or a ball, a table lamp or torch and cello tape. And even you can use one small picture of a child, one small sticker of the child, and you can stick that on the globe or a ball with cello tape. Now keep a globe on the table and set the lamp in front of the globe such that it gets light from the lamp. And children, you have to do this activity in a dark room. Now observe which side is in the light. It means which side of the globe has day. And the dark side represents night. Now find out the sticker of a child. Is this in a light area or in dark area? Now, slowly rotate the globe. Now observe which side is in dark and which side has light. Now again find out the sticker of the child is in which side. So children, you will observe the side of the globe that has lit by the lamp will experience day. And as the globe rotates, the side now becomes dark and experiences night. And you will find that at a time only one side of the globe gets light, so that will experience day, and other side which do not get light will experience night. Children, our today's next topic is eclipse, which is also called in Hindi grahan. As you learn that the Earth revolves around the sun, same as the moon revolves around the Earth. So due to this revolution, the moon and Earth keep changing their position. So due to revolution, sometimes the sun, the moon and the Earth all come in a straight line. And in that case, shadow of the Earth and the moon are formed. These shadows are called as eclipse. Children, there are two types of eclipse. Solar eclipse means Surya Grahan and lunar eclipse, which is called as Chandra Grahan. In solar eclipse, the moon comes between the Earth and sun and the shadow of the moon is cast on the Earth. Whereas in lunar eclipse, Earth comes between the sun and the moon and the shadow of moon is formed. Let's discuss about each in detail. First, solar eclipse. Children, when the moon comes between the sun and the earth, it blocks the light from the sun. Thus, a shadow of moon is formed on the earth. This causes solar eclipse. Just look at here. You can see here, when the moon comes between the earth and sun, the shadow of the moon will form on the earth. This condition is called as solar eclipse. So, during a solar eclipse, people who fall under this shadow area are not able to see the sun as it gets blocked by the moon. For them, it becomes dark as a night during the daytime only. Okay, and during a total solar eclipse, people who fall under this shadow sees the sun decrease into a crescent. And when the sun is completely covered, as you can see on the screen, as the sun is completely covered by the moon, the beautiful ring called corona is seen around the darkened sun. And in this condition, the people who fall under the shadow area will experience night during the day. It occurs only for few seconds. Now next is lunar eclipse. Look at the screen. During revolutions, when the earth comes between the sun and the moon, then lunar eclipse is formed. In this eclipse, the shadow of the earth falls on the moon, and due to which the moon appears dark. This condition is called as lunar eclipse. Just see this video clip carefully on the screen. As you find that the size of the moons keep on decreasing. The reason is that discovered by the earth means the shadow of earth is cast on this, and the people on the earth will able to see the moon like this. Okay, so perform the following activity to understand the solar and lunar eclipse. For this, you need a torch and two balls. One small ball and one big ball. Small ball will represent the moon and the large ball to represent the earth, or even you can use a globe in place of a large ball. Okay. Now, set the torch or a lamp and the small ball in a straight line. Here, lamp or torch will represent the sun, small ball will represent moon, and you have to use a big ball or globe. Arrange the apparatus as shown in the picture. You will observe the shadow of the moon will form on the earth. Okay, and this is the forming of solar eclipse, as the portion of earth is not getting light from the sun. Next, do the same procedure for forming of lunar eclipse. You have to do one change, not change the position of the earth and moon. Okay, in that condition, earth was aside and small ball was kept in the middle. But in this condition, the earth should be between and the sun and the moon will be aside. Now switch on the torch or lamp, you will observe the shadow of the earth on the moon. Okay, and the moon is dark now, as it is getting the light from the sun. This condition is called as lunar eclipse. So children, I hope you all have learned clearly about the movement of earth, how the blocking of lights forms many natural phenomena on the earth. Okay, this is all for today. Thank you very much, everyone.